In the previous movie, we generated and configured a HumanIK skeleton for our DOTA2 Courier. In this movie, we'll build on our work by skinning the character's mesh onto its skeleton and then adding a simple facial rig so we can animate his expressions later on. Open the file DOTA2 Courier Part 2 Start.mlt from the provided files linked below, or use your own scene. As we mentioned in the previous movie, this courier is available in two levels of detail in accordance with the DOTA Workshop technical guidelines. While the low poly version is required by DOTA 2 for the in-game character, the high poly version is entirely optional and will only be displayed in the game's portrait view. Here, we'll skin the low poly version first and then copy the resulting skin weights onto the high poly version. In the outliner, select the faceplates LOD1 and face LOD1 groups and hide them for now. Also hide the courier's head joint chain. Select the courier mesh and the courier's hips joint. Go to Skin, Smooth Bind, Options. By default, Maya LT uses a geodesic voxel binding method to skin a mesh to influencing joints. This volumetric binding method calculates skin weights by converting the mesh into voxels to determine the distance to each joint. The falloff attribute determines the smoothness versus rigidity of this binding method. Set it to 1 so each joint's weight influence tapers off rapidly. The resolution attribute determines the density of the voxelized mesh, which impacts the binding accuracy. Set it to 512. Also, turn off allow multiple bind poses and set max influences to 2 so every vertex is bound to at most 2 joints. Click Apply. MyLT creates a new skin cluster node for the skinned object as well as a bind pose node for all joints. The bind pose node stores the influence joint's transform attributes at the time of the bind. You can return to this bind pose at any time by selecting a joint and going to Skin, Go to Bind Pose. Select the propeller mesh and its respective joint chain and apply a new smooth bind using the same settings. Now unhide the face LOD1 group and head joint chain. We want to bind the courier's face objects to their respective joints. Select the left eyebrow and its matching joint. In the Smooth Bind Options window, change the Bind To dropdown to Selected Joints since we don't actually want to use its child joint. Also set Bind Method to Closest Distance and click Apply. Repeat this process for the other face objects. Unhide the remaining faceplates LOD1 group. Using the previous settings, bind each faceplate to its associated joint. Before we go any further, let's animate our courier to preview the skin results. Open the HumanIK character controls and set Source to Control Rig. The control rig appears on top of the base skeleton and is comprised of FK effectors in yellow and IK effectors in red and blue. You can also select them in the Control tab's character representation. We'll cover the control rig in greater detail in the next movie. For now, we'll just use it to set a few animation keys. Make sure you're in full body mode and that Auto key is enabled. Then select an effector and press S to set a key at frame 1. In full body mode, all effectors are keyed whether or not you pose them. Now, go to frame 10 and lower the hips effector to pose the courier in a squat stance. Next, rotate both shoulder effectors 90 degrees down in object space, and bend both elbow effectors 90 degrees. Scrub the time slider to see our courier squat. This is a decent start, though we still need to adjust skin weights in certain areas such as the shoulders, the elbows, the ankles, and the face. Hide the IK-FK effectors and show the skeleton. Then select the courier and go to Skin, Paint Skin Weights Tool, Options. Maya LT displays each joint's skin influence as a gradient, which can help you diagnose why a limb may not be deforming as expected. For example, the shoulder should be entirely bound to its arm joint. But if you select the spine joint, you can see that it's partially influenced by this as well. To fix this, we could paint our skin weights where needed using the Artisan toolset. However, since this is a fairly low polygonal model, it'll be quicker to block out the weights manually. Switch from Paint to Select mode, then select one shoulder vertex and press Shift right angle bracket to grow the selection to neighboring vertices. Repeat this process until you've selected all the arm vertices up to the elbow. Select the left arm in the influences list and drag the value slider to the right to set the weight to 1. Notice how the shoulder geometry immediately straightens out. You can confirm the skin weights themselves were updated by toggling back to paint mode. Repeat this process to skin the other left-sided parts of the courier mesh. You can adjust the skin weights in iterative passes for greater control. Start by blocking out the main influences, then go back to polish areas prone to distortions such as articulation points. To minimize scrolling through the influence list, use the size controls to view more influence at once. You can also use the pin icon to display only the selected joints. To avoid accidentally selecting a joint when you really want vertices, use the Select Joint object to toggle joint selection. At any point, you can mirror the skin weights by returning to frame 1, the initial bind pose, selecting the mesh, and going to Skin, Mirror Skin Weights. Mirroring your skin weights can be a time saver during the initial weight pass. However, don't forget to go back and finalize those weights before you move on. To properly skin your mesh, we recommend you create additional poses using the control rig to cover the courier's full range of motion. We've included a fully skinned courier for reference in the provided scene files linked with this movie. Next, in order to animate facial expressions more easily, we'll connect the face joints to a control rig. Import DOTA2 Courier Face GUI.fbx from the provided files. Move it to the side for now. These controls are made out of NURBS curves that are constrained in translation within a specific range of values. You can also create these controls using MEL to provide more user customization. Here we use the script as a basis for our control rig. We want to connect these control curves to the corresponding joints using set-driven keys. Go to Animate, Set-driven Key, Set. Let's start with the eyes. Select Eyes Control and click Load Driver. Then select Courier Eyes and click Load Driven. Select the driver's Translate X attribute and the driven's Rotate X attribute. Click Key to set a driven key between these attributes. Now move the control to the left and rotate the joint to next. Set a new key. Repeat this to set a driven key in the opposite direction. Set the control back to 0, and then set 3 new keys to drive the joint's Rotate Z attribute using the control's Translate Y attribute. Our courier can now look around using this simple control. Select Courier Eyes and open the graph editor. The animation curves represent the connection between the translation and rotation attributes. Make sure both curves' tangents are set to linear in order to remove any easing in and out. Repeat this process to set up the blink controls. This time, each control drives an eye joint as well as its matching eyebrow joint to add some realism to the blink. The eyebrows also have independent controls, useful for surprised or frowning expressions. When you connect a joint's attribute to multiple controls, Maya LT creates a blend weight node to combine the set-driven key's animation curves. This way, you can mix the controls together for a greater number of facial expressions. Connect the remaining lip joints to the mouth controls. The mouth control works similarly to the eyes control we first rigged. With each mouth corner controlled separately, we can add even more expressions to our courier's library. While the open mouth control simulates the jaw rotation, which you can use to accentuate your expressions. In addition to his face, our courier has four different faceplates to help reflect his current state. To toggle between them, we can drive the rotation on the x-axis using the faceplate control. For the bind pose state, we want to set a key on all the faceplate's x-rotations while they're zeroed out. Then for each state, we'll rotate the unwanted faceplates negative 75 degrees to reveal the selected plate. Using the techniques covered so far, connect the propeller joint's rotation to the propeller control so you can quickly toggle between its different states. The last thing left to do is to bind the high-poly version of our courier to the skeleton. Switch couriers by toggling their respective layers. Bind the courier mesh to the hips hierarchy. Next, bind the face LOD0 group and faceplates to their respective joints. Make sure you've reset your facial control rig beforehand. Now select the low poly courier mesh and then the high poly one and go to Skin, Copy Skin Weights options. By default, Maya LT copies skin weight information of the source mesh to the destination mesh based on the point distance of the overlapping meshes. You can choose up to three ways to associate the skeleton match. In our case, we'll leave it as is. The high poly courier now uses the same skin values as the low poly one. Repeat this process to copy the skin weights associated with the face elements and plates if necessary. In the next movie, we'll configure our HumanIK control rig and start blocking some animations for our courier.